Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker. And I'm just here with a bit of an old Imperious Impressions. This time it's of Titan Souls on that there PC. For those of you who do not know, Titan Souls is a... I think it terms itself an action puzzler. Developed by, I think the team is called Acid Nerve, and published by Devolver Digital, who are the only reason I actually know about this game, because apparently, without me specifically requesting this, I think I've been put on Devolver Digital's press mailing list, so I just randomly got a key for this game a couple of days ago, at time of recording. I had no idea what Titan Souls was. I had never heard of it. I hadn't played the demo, because apparently there was a demo. I had no idea. And then I got my key and was like, eh, I'll give it a go. And I played it, and it's great. As you can see there, keeps a count of how many deaths you've had, how many bosses you've killed, because this game is kind of an extravagant boss rush. I literally just recorded about 20 minutes of this with my new mic. You can probably, hopefully, tell the difference. However, I ever so slightly ballsed it up. Because I managed to leave my mic off when I was recording. So that was fun. That was grand. But yeah, so I'm just going to start a new save, run through the first four bosses, and tell you a bit about the game. So there you see we had ourselves a bow and an arrow. Because you see, this game is kind of based around one larger central conceit. Let me just quickly move my mic a bit closer there. It's based around one larger central conceit, and that is one hit, one kill for you and many of the enemies. Because you have one attack. That. And pressing the attack button again just calls the arrow back to you. You only ever have one arrow that you always have to get back to you. You have no other way to attack. Beyond that, you can roll, and if you hold down A, you can run. Those are all of your capabilities in this game. Roll and shoot and call back. That's it. And with these very small, and with this very small amount of abilities and a one-hit KO for you, should the enemy so much as look at you funny, you have to try to get through this entire game that consists of a series of Titan fights against various different kinds of bosses. In the vein of Shadow of the Colossus. However, the repetition and difficulty of the game has been compared to Dark Souls. Indeed, it kind of wears its inspirations, the twin inspirations of Dark Souls and Shadow of the Colossus, on its sleeve with the name Titan Souls. Souls, Soul Series, Titan, Colossus. And indeed, just visually, you can see, like, visually it has a lot more to do with Shadow of the Colossus than it does with Dark Souls. Because right now, the way I describe how it looks at the moment is kind of a pixel art Shadow of the Colossus if it was made by the dude who made Fez, if Phil Fish was in charge of the art creation. Because it's got kind of that, and I know a lot of people hate Phil Fish, and I don't even particularly enjoy Fez, because it's basically entirely a puzzle game, and I don't like puzzle games. But it's got kind of this, kind of very polished, like, pixel art, but not from any specific generation aesthetic that I really like. If there's any pixel aesthetic I like, it's this kind of very smoothed out, very polished pixel art aesthetic, which I found Fez had. But it's that if it was doing the kind of temple from Shadow of the Colossus or the majority of the environments from Ico. It's got a very kind of Team Ico via Phil Fish aesthetic that I quite like. Although, it must be said, the doors that scream at you, the eye doors that glare at you and then scream at you do freak me out a bit. Okay. The first boss, represented by a picture of a heart, is, if I recall correctly, a giant fucking slime. Yep, there it is. Big sloppy slime with a heart in the middle. Now, the way you have to fight this boss is you have to basically kind of break it down into a series of different parts. I am curious, however, as to if you could... I'm wondering if you aimed it just right. Could you kill it in a single hit? Like, I don't know, because you have, the basic goal is split it up into enough parts so that the heart just ends up on its own. Okay, but we're about to die. Oh god. Oh god, we're so dead, we're so dead. Flee. Where's the arrow? 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 I got cocky, this didn't go well. Oh, that, yep, okay, I died. Yep, that was me being dumb. I will admit that. Yeah. But, yeah, I completely lost track of what I was saying there. I got too caught up in the game. But, this is actually what... By the way, this is the easiest boss at the minute. Yeah. Yeah, like, I'm wondering if you can just one-hit KO this boss. I've tried. It doesn't seem to me like you can. I mean, like... But yeah, so the basic idea is you have to split it up into enough parts so that the heart ends up kind of bouncing on its own and then kill the heart. Shit, need to get past. Also, it's a good idea to attempt to actually avoid the slime trails that the slimes leave behind, because I believe... Yep, dead again. Because I believe those slime trails will kill you. Well, they won't kill you, but you will slow down, and then inevitably one of the fat slimy bastards will just all over you. And no one wants to be all over, do they? No one wants to be... I've heard that it's rather unpleasant. And no, I'm not turning into a denizen of Rock Bottom from SpongeBob SquarePants. Who the fuck are you? I can't understand your accent. I'm a grown-up, ladies and gentlemen. I'm 21 and play video games for a living. Okay, this is going a bit better. We need to get as far away from these slimes as possible and call our little arrow back. Okay. Shit. These small ones are actually... For as threatening as the big ones look, it's the small ones that'll fuck you up. Yes, we killed it. Okay. Finally. But yeah, as threatening as the big ones look, it's the small ones that are worse, because you can get around the big ones really easy, but the small fuckers just bounce more, and they bounce further, and they chase you. It's awful. But yeah, so let's just call our arrow back. And then we're gonna get struck by arcane power! That's a Dead Mines joke, I believe. First boss of the Dead Mines. Can you tell I played World of Warcraft for way too long? Oh, yes. Arcane power. I've been playing a lot of Swtor recently. I love Swtor, but I'll say this. The dungeons aren't as fun as the ones in World of Warcraft. Just saying. But yeah, so that's one boss done. That's actually one of the easier bosses, or at least I found it the easiest boss to fight. Also, random thing, there's a little bit of attention to detail in this game that I quite like. You can roll just about anywhere. You cannot roll upstairs. You will just hit the stairs. However, if I say go up these taller stairs and roll down, yep, you keep rolling the whole way. I don't know, it's a small thing, but I like it. It's just small bits of attention to detail that I like. It's that kind of thing that can really make a game, you know, when they paid attention to those small details. Okay, I also know how to beat this boss. It's a brain in a cube. What we basically have to do is avoid it. Cause it... Yep, killed me. It swings around like that. Whenever it goes on one of the, you probably saw there, there's some tiles with pictures of fire. Fire belches up through the center. What we basically need to do is get it to hit one of those tiles, shoot at it, shoot an arrow at it, from behind the fire, so the arrow goes through the fire and melts the ice cube. And then we have to hit the brain itself. Damn it, missed. And we got hit. But yeah, you saw what happened there. Arrow went through. It did catch fire. We just need to hit it with that. Okay. I'm gonna try and fight the ones that are the least difficult for me first, because this one, you see, there's got kind of a... That one is like... This one over here is a cube with an eye on it, and that thing... I died to that thing more than I've died to any of the other bosses this early on in the game. And trust me, you will die a lot. The only reason that I'm not dying every 10 fucking seconds is quite literally... Because I just fought all of these bosses, like 5 fucking minutes ago. God damn it. And it's... Oh, no, it's not flying towards me. It's jumping at me now. Oh, shit. There we go. Now it's just its own exposed brain. So now it's just going to kind of turn into the same moveset as the slime. Until we hit it in the fucking cerebral cortex with our arrow and suck that fucker out. Ultimate power! Okay. And by the way, this whole shebang, fucking meaningless in terms of the actual game. Like, I believe, as far as I can tell, the goal is, again, kind of akin to Shadow of the Colossus and Dark Souls, actually. Huh. Dark Souls and Demon Souls. I don't know if Bloodborne does this, but Dark Souls and Demon Souls and Shadow of the Colossus all kind of have the same goal. Collect the souls of these monsters. But, different reasons, but it's always collect the soul of these monsters. That had not occurred to me until just now. But yeah, in terms of what little story there seems to be at the moment, we have to collect the souls of these monsters. For what goal? I don't know. These monsters are called Titans. But in terms of gameplay, means nothing. We never get more hit points, we never get more arrows, we never improve our shitty little roll. This is all we have for the entire game. You just have to get better at the game if you want to survive. Oh dear. It must be said though, I've only fought the first four bosses of this game, and this guy's gonna kick the shit out of me. I've only fought the first four bosses of this game, but already, just because of how short these boss fights are, there's a lot of kind of possibilities for how to there's a wide range of possibilities for what the bosses could actually do, you know, what the gimmick you have to work around is. You know, there's a lot of possibilities there. They could do a lot of really interesting stuff, and it seems like they already have, from what little I've played of the game, and from, like, occasional screenshots I've seen. There's some really interesting-looking bosses, and if there's one thing I love in a game, it's interesting enemy design, both visually and in terms of their behavior. I like interesting enemy design. That's one thing that will just completely... I'll be completely smitten by a game if you've got interesting enemy design. If you're wondering what we have to do with this guy, we have to try to get him we have to try to get him to face us. Ah, shit. We have to try to get him to face us, and then, as he's charging up the laser, shoot him in the eye. And that will one-hit kill him. Only problem is, it can be a bit of a pisser trying to get the guy to actually face you. Because you have to stay relatively close to him in order to, like, attempt to control his movement. And he moves deceptively quickly. Like, he moves, like, strangely quickly. So if you stay close to him, he is on your ass, basically, constantly. And we killed him. Yes. 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 Jump you. Sorry. Let's draw him out. I will draw out your sword. There we go. Arcane power! So I'm running out of jokes for this. Really am. Next thing you know, I'm going to start having to sing, you know, a song from the end of Jesus Christ Superstar. You know, when Judas comes back. Oh, dear. Jesus, Buddha, is he where it's at? Is he where you are? Could Muhammad move a mountain, or was that just PR? Okay. Sorry. I won't sing. I will attempt to avoid singing. Okay. Next boss. This is probably... I'm really annoyed, actually, because I got a good half hour of footage of this game when I recorded earlier. And now, because I know how to beat these bosses, I'm probably barely going to break 15 minutes, which is upsetting, but hey, it'll make the upload smaller. Okay. And it makes me look better at the game. Okay. Now I have to deal with this guy. I put a weird amount of, like... When I first came to this, I thought that, like, you just couldn't fight this guy until you'd beaten the other three. Because, you know, the other three are like, what? A heart, an eye, and a brain. This guy appears to be somewhat broken. So I assumed that, like, you wouldn't be able to wake him up until then. Apparently, no, you can just wake him up normally and he's fine. As you can see right away, you need to shoot him in the chest. Because he's got kind of a... Because he has got a bit of a glowing fuck me light in the chest there. Glowing fuck me light that ever finished. And yeah, this is kind of a little area where the boss just can't hit you. However, it's also basically impossible to hit the boss. I'm gonna try, actually, if he does shit. He's not gonna spit his hand out over it. Yeah, you just can't hit him from this distance. I mean, you could probably fire your arrow that distance, but really what you need to do is you need to be relatively close when he changes hands. and hopefully not get smacked around the back of the head like I do. But yeah, you need to be relatively close to the guy when he changes hands and then try to hit him in the glowing fuck me light. And that guy, honestly, out of the Titans I've fought so far, that guy is the most obviously Shadow of the Colossus-esque. Because to my mind, he almost vaguely resembles kind of a mixture of the last Colossus. I say the last Colossus. He kind of resembles the last Colossus mixed with, I think, the third Colossus. And I died. But yeah, he kind of resembles those to me. Because he's got kind of the kind of almost duck build lips and general design. However, he's in one place and smashing things with big fists like the final Colossus. This guy is probably going to kick the shit out of me. And you can kind of tell I've recorded a fair bit today to test my microphone because my throat's going already. And by the way, no, I've got no idea what the hell's going on with this Shadow of the Colossus-esque text. It's like in its own, but shit. The in its own bullshit fantasy language, I've got no idea what that is or why that's there. I'm going to take a swig of water here. It occurred to me, I could actually mute my mic. In order to do that, I have to, I actually have to lean in and press the fucking button. And you can probably hear that, so probably not going to be making use of that. Somehow. Don't think I will. Okay. I'm also hoping that didn't fuck with the recording. Actually, give me a minute. I'm going to quickly check to make sure that didn't fuck with the recording. Okay, that doesn't appear to have fucked with the recording. Okay. Let's try and wake this bad boy up. There we go. Roar!
No, I do not approve. I am a stone Skeksis.
I haven't even fucking seen the Dark Crystal. Shit. But yeah, you can see there, we have to try and shoot him in the changing of the hands, or the changing of the guard, or whatever the hell you want to call it. I want to call it the changing of the guard, because that amuses me. That tickles my funny bone. But, which, by the way, is a horrifying saying, isn't it? Tickles my funny bone. Yes, it tickles the inside of your flesh. No one wants anything to be their funny bone. Oh dear. Yeah, I think I'm having more difficulty on this guy than having. But then again, I'm gonna be honest. I've had more practice in the other bosses than I have on this guy. Because the first time I woke him up was when I was recording. When I was recording earlier, the failed recording was the first time I'd woke this guy up. I had tried all the other bosses like several times. On the other one. Hence why I had like 47 deaths on that. I don't know how many deaths I have in this. We'll check at the end of the video, but. Come on, big one. You can almost say this dude's, it's trapped behind him. You can almost say that this dude is, built like a brick shit house. You get it, because he's actually made of brick. Unrelated, while we're talking about, we're not talking about it right now, but while we're, talking about things that share some aesthetic with, Shadow of the Colossus and kind of Team Ico games, there's this one game that I basically never hear mentioned, but I really enjoyed, and I thought it took a few hints, visually and in terms of its storyline, from Team Ico, though it was a lot more kind of a boy and his dog kind of story than, say Ico, and that was Margine in the Forsaken Kingdom, I believe it was. It kind of had a similar kind of ruined temples aesthetic, you know, kind of ruined, slightly overgrown. Very nearly came back. It had kind of similar ruined temples aesthetic, but the whole deal was that you were playing as this one lad, and you had this kind of big, kind of doofy friend creature called the Margine, and you were fighting kind of a bunch of shadow creatures and things that, and I think like people and animals that were infected with this awful shadow, that which is the reason the kingdom was forsaken, and all the bosses were kind of, I believe, kind of massively shadowed up people and heroes from said kingdom. It was really cool and really fun, and I really liked the Margine character. I can't remember what his name was, but I really enjoyed that game. It's for PS3 and Xbox 360. Yes! Killed the fucker! And it was a really I love how shocked he looks. I hadn't noticed that. He's like,
Oh my god, you hit me! That kind of smart.
Okay, let's draw, pull this out. Boom! And yeah, then he just dies and sinks into the ground when you pull it out. And yeah, ultimate power, whatever. You know, it's a really good game that no one ever talks about. Okay, there we go. So now with that done, with all those bosses dead, and me feeling like I probably either, to some people I probably look vaguely skilled, to other people I probably look like a fucking idiot. Depends on how good they are at games, generally. I don't say I'm good at games, that's one thing. I will never claim that I am good at games. Shut up, Kaya. But, I'd ask you to oh shit, can you actually? Oh! You can climb up there. That's cool, I didn't know you could climb up vines. I'm gonna have to look. From what I actually read a bit of a review of this game shortly before recording it from, I think it was Rock Paper Shotgun did a review. And it talked about how in the overworld between the boss fights, there's some kind of hidden secrets and Easter eggs. But yeah, so now we've defeated the bosses of this area, this big door opens, and we can continue on. Now, before you think that this game is literally just kind of small hub areas like that, and again we're kind of still in a very Ico via Fez looking area here, before you think that the entire game is just kind of small hubs like that, we're actually going to head out here to this elevator. I'm going to lift it up with kind of a indication of us on the wall there, with an eye representing us and bone and arrow. We go up. And we are in a much larger overworld. A very large overworld, in fact. I believe there's a big old door up here that we can't open, if I recall correctly. Yep. And yeah, you actually need to go out and find the other hubs, the other bosses to kill in order to advance. And yeah, that you can see here, this is a much bigger area to explore. Much wider, much fancier, I like it, there's a lot more to see and do, it's quite nifty. Oh, I think this might be a boss hub area, let's see if we can't get up here. I want to actually find another boss area before I end the recording, because I didn't in the last one. Okay, there's a big frightening door up here, oh, what's this? Well, not even a door, or a cave entrance, really. Let's have a look. Please don't be a boss, I don't want to die. I don't want to walk in and die immediately. Oh no, this isn't a boss. It's just a big, scary kind of chasm. I like that, the dead silence underground. It's very atmospheric. Oh, would you look at that? You even leave like a trail in the snow. Yeah, when you roll, you actually leave a trail. That's really cool. Again, like, attention to detail. There's a lot of, Again, you can even, like, roll through these to... Wait. Yeah. You can even roll through those to fuck them up. It's really cool. And I wouldn't... Okay, yeah, we found a boss hub. Yeah, I wouldn't... I'm imagining... You know what? Let's try this. I'm imagining... Yep. That this is a thing that you can do. And... I'd imagine something happens if you light all of them. So let's quickly try this before we end the video. See what happens, if anything. Get that a bit more of it, exactly. Yep, got it. Shot it from off screen, but we got it. Okay, an even longer shot. Ah! I think I know what we... I think I get it. We have to... Yep, I get it. We have to do this, and then line up a shot with that. Nope, not quite. Line up a shot here to unlock that door. Nope. Ah, oh, just missed. Okay. Let's try one more time. There it is! Ah, it's so cool. Environmental puzzles and boss fights, ladies and gentlemen. Environmental puzzles and boss fights. That's what this game is. But yeah, no, so to sum up, now that I've gotten a good 25 minutes of this game after running around exploring the environment and being just like, oh, it's so cool. this game is really cool. The boss fights are really enjoyable, you know. They're difficult, they're challenging, but it's not frustrating. It's not bullshit. The boss fights appear to be really well designed, to the point at which, like, every time you lose, you're sitting there and you're like, ah, fucker! But you're like, the game isn't robbing me here. You know, the game isn't bullshitting you. You can see what you have to do a lot of the time. You're just not good enough to do it yet, so you have to keep trying and keep getting it. And then when you get it, wave of relief. Wave of just like, ah. Which is the kind of thing that, you know, it's the kind of thing that's got that kind of, you know, struggle, ah, thing that really been popularized by Dark Souls, but a lot of people, myself included, and I know a lot of you ladies and gentlemen who are watching this at home, you know that that's a massive reason to play games in the past, is just that feeling of success after, you know, that much adversity. This game really has that in spades with the boss fight. It looks really nice. I love the way it looks. It's got a very deep, it's got a very, you know, enjoyable atmosphere. There's, especially like when it opens up, there appears to be, you know, a lot of, kind of just interesting little things, interesting little bits of attention to detail, a lot of little niggling bits that are just kind of make the experience of the game. And indeed, you know, you got the kind of environmental puzzles, kind of cool little environmental puzzles. I don't know whether or not that door I opened's optional. I have heard there are a number of optional titans in the game, so I imagine there's a lot of these puzzles that just open optional titan rooms. It's just fun, you know. It's just fun. It's challenging. And it's enjoyable, and it looks really nice. It just seems to be a really solid game. It's out for sale right now. As ever, there's going to be a link in the description of this video to the Steam store page where you can buy it. It is currently, I believe, £11 or £10.99 British pounds at the moment. I really like it. If it looks like the kind of thing you'd enjoy, you know, check it out. If you like Dark Souls, check this out. It's a great game. I would say, don't play it without a gamepad. Because I wouldn't play this game without a gamepad. I don't know how I feel about games that you have to have a gamepad for, really. I think like most people who are serious with PC gaming probably own a gamepad or own at least one gamepad. I've been thinking of investing in another one just so I can get some, you know, split screen co-op on some games on the PC. But you know, if you've got a gamepad and if this looks like your kind of thing, go pick it up. It's not that expensive. And it's really fun. I've heard that depending on how awful you are at it, it can last anywhere from like 5 to 8 hours. For a tenner, that's a good amount of gameplay, a good amount of quality gameplay. But as ever, what matters more isn't the amount of time you have in the game, but the quality of the game, and it appears to be a damn good game. But yeah, so link in the description if you want to buy it. I recommend it, but that's going to have to be all for me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Sardis Thinker, and as always, keep calm and carry on. Good day. Well, I hope you enjoyed watching that video as much as I enjoyed making it. Well, I say that, I could have been having a really shitty day when I recorded that. You can't tell, and I certainly can't. Pre-recorded message and all that. Anyway, just here to say that I have a Twitter account that you can follow if you want occasional updates of random thoughts from me, and that if you're feeling generous, feel free to donate to my Patreon campaign. Every penny donated there makes life easier for me generally and slowly goes towards me getting a better gaming PC. Well, that's that. It's over. Leave. Now. Now!
Do not seek the Sideways Thinker. Do not seek the Pardoner.